Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Bharti, moderator for the conference call. Welcome to NATH Biogen Q4 FY21 earnings conference call hosted by Go India Advisors. As a reminder, all participants are in listen-only mode. Later, we will conduct a question and answer session. At that time, if you have a question, please press star and one on your telephone keypad. Please note, this conference is recorded. I would now like to hand over the floor to Ms. Sheetal Kanduja of Go India Advisors. Thank you, and over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Bharti. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the NATH Biogen's earnings call to discuss the FY21 results. We have on the call with us today Mr. Satish Kagliwal, Managing Director, Mr. Devinder Khurana, CFO, and Mr. V.N. Kulkarni from Research. We must remind you that the discussion on today's call may include certain forward-looking statements and must be therefore viewed in conjunction with the risks that the company faces. I will now hand over to Mr. Kagliwal for his opening remarks. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you, Sheetal. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being with us on this call today. And I hope you and your loved ones are keeping safe in these difficult times. Friends, the second wave of corona has hit all the sectors of economy once again at a very crucial time, affecting the movement of men and materials, more particularly for agriculture sector, which is undergoing preparations for the kharif season. Despite the restrictions imposed, your company, through its supply chain team, were able to deliver goods in time in India. The kharif season is all upbeat this year due to a very favorable monsoon prediction. The sowings are progressing very well across India. Our sales and marketing teams have been taking extra efforts to deliver seeds to our farmers. They are even giving home deliveries wherever required when the farmers are not able to reach the shops in time. Following all the necessary COVID protocols, pre-seasonal activities were undertaken effectively. We are now, this season, also using new technologies like sharing short videos of our product testimonials to the select farmer groups. We are also using social media, multimedia, messaging services, and telecalls to reach the farmer and also our channel partners. This is all to remind them, help recall our products. We continue our efforts to further enhance our management bandwidth by bringing in talent and highly experienced professionals, be it addition of chief people officer, new business lead for our EHN vertical, and many more at different levels. Now I would like to touch upon some new things which are happening in the company, more particularly on the product front. We launched two new products in our PHN vertical, Winol Granules and Winpro Goli. Both are soil conditioners and help in improving the quality of soil and also raise a good crop. They will help us create a basket of products for our plant health nutrition vertical. This also helps us in getting aligned with the soil amendment market globally. Government of India enhanced the cotton seed prices by rupees 37 per packet this year. This is surely helping realizing a better value this year. Friends, following all the necessary protocols, we have put in extraordinary efforts to promote our unique cotton products, namely NBC-10, Sanket, Jumbo, and Rana this year. The response to these efforts is visible. The threat of illegal HTBT cotton continues to affect the organized industry. We, through our associations, are working very hard to request Government of India to regularize HTBT cotton and also, in the meantime, also stop the menace of illegal supply of illegal CBT through governmental intervention. We have been investing heavily in our hybrid research program ever since the inclusion of Dr. Ishkumar and Dr. Kulkarni in our team. I'm very happy to announce that we have launched 4 new products this year in different segments of hybrid study, and they are Dhoom, Dharak, and Dharak Gold. And the response to these new products launching has been phenomenal. Before I hand over to Mr. Khurana for his remarks, I'm indeed pleased to share the announcement of maiden dividend this year by your company. We're also exploring various capital restructuring plans about which Mr. Khurana will give further details. Finally, we are continuously focusing on strengthening the organization, be it in the field of new product discovery, product development, sales and marketing, working with new technologies, new linkages. This all towards our resolve to create long-term value for all our stakeholders and increasing national agricultural productivity. Thank you, friends. Over to Mr. Khurana.
Thank you, Mr. Kagliwal. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for joining us today. I hope you would have seen our earnings presentation, which was released yesterday. As Mr. Kagliwal pointed, we have had a very difficult year on the account of COVID. The pandemic hit us at a crucial time last year, just at the beginning of Kharif, and it did impact our cotton seed sale. However, despite a difficult operating year, we have been able to deliver 10% revenue growth this year. Before we start discussing the operating and financial performance, I would like to touch upon what Mr. Kagliwal spoke about. We have been wanting to reward our shareholders for their faith and trust they have shown in us. To begin with, we are recommending a maiden 20% dividend. We are seriously contemplating buyback and working with our merchant bankers for the same. However, this would require lending institution approval and would take some time. I understand that there is a natural concern regarding funding of some of these options, and I would like to address that. We are contemplating buyback, and as and when we get the approval for the same, which might happen in Q2 or Q3 of this fiscal, my working capital requirements would be quite eased. And since the working capital requirement will suitably ease out, sufficient funds will be available with the company. If you all recall, last year we announced a major shift in strategy as we moved towards de-risking and diversifying our portfolio. We took significant steps to ensure that besides paddy and cotton segment, our other portfolio would be strengthened to create a more de-risked business model. I'm happy to report that we have been able to deliver strong growth in each of our verticals of vegetable, field crops, and supplement. Our vegetable portfolio volumetrically grew by 13% this year. As you are aware, this is a high margin portfolio with EBITDA margin of 60%, contribution margins of 60% and above. If we see the growth value, it was over 14%. This vertical was strengthened with new marketing head joined, and he has undertaken many new initiatives by defining new territories and managers. We are also in the process of launching multiple new products in tomato, which would have high level disease resistance assisted by markers. Inocra, which will have high level disease resistance with short internodal distances. In Chile, with high yield and excellent virus resistance. In cucumber, with high yield and no bitterness. And in bitter gourd, high virus resistance with high yield. This would further strengthen our vegetable portfolio. The other biggest contribution to revenue came from field crops, besides paddy and cotton. This portfolio performed quite well, and the strong growth seen here is a testament of the wide acceptability of our bajra and wheat products. This portfolio contributed 17% to the revenue this year as compared to 15% last year. Maize grew by 32% and bajra by 10%. Wheat also grew by 34%. However, jawar declined. The overall volumetric growth was 10% and revenue-wise around 14%. Coming to plant nutrient segment, this segment was massively impacted because of COVID and it delivered a moderate growth of 80%. The product continues to give a margin of around 70% plus, and in revenue contribution, it maintained a 10% of the overall sales. It is and it remains a wonder product with excellent margins. We have high expectations from this product and have set up a sole vertical to enhance sales and margins. Apart from the same, we are also diversifying within the segment into our different products this year, for which the details would be given in the subsequent quarters. I will now discuss our cotton portfolio. Cotton delivered a 5% growth this year. The portfolio took a significant hit due to COVID in both the waves. We saw significant sales return of 27% this year as compared to 11% in the previous year. The distributors were unable to place the product and subsequently we had an inventory buildup. We expect the cotton inventory to normalize over the next 2 years, but we have already rationalized the cotton production to absorb the higher inventory. Government has done away with royalty on cotton seeds. Although the reduction is only around 20 rupees per packet in volumes, it would have a reasonable impact. We would continue to be present in cotton and paddy, simultaneously enhancing our efforts in other crops too. I will now briefly talk about our financial performance. Our top line grew by a moderate 10%, which was largely driven by good operational performance in vegetable and field crops. The growth, although not matching the guidance, was still commendable pursuant to the pandemic situation, which hampered farmer personal movement simultaneously. However, we maintained our gross contribution margin of 56% this year, with a net profit margin of around 18%. We have maintained a tight working capital cycle. However, it has been adversely impacted on account of cotton sales return. The same is being rationalized with reduced cotton production since we have sufficient inventory of the same. Luckily, the cotton seed can be easily carried forward for many years. The debtor period has further reduced from 140 to 130 days. We plan to continue to prune it more. The finance cost has marginally increased from 2.34% to 2.87% of the sales. The same is on account of enhanced working capital limits. I would also like to point out that the promoters have considerably reduced the pledge of their holding in the company to under 20%, and it is further being reduced. Before I open the floor for questions, I would like to discuss FY22 outlook. While the COVID situation seems to be getting under control, it would still impact Kharif of this year. We hence expect to deliver a top line growth of around 15-20% in FY22. However, we will be able to maintain our contribution and EBITDA and PAT margins, of which I am reasonably sure. With this, I will open the floor for questions.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. If you have a question, please press star and one on your telephone keypad and wait for your turn to ask the question. If you would like to withdraw your request, you may do so by pressing star and one again. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have a question, please press star and one on your telephone keypad. First question comes from Nitin Awasthi from East India Securities. Please go ahead.
Hello, sir. Just had a few questions on various topics, so I'll just go through them one by one. Firstly, on the bonus issue, you mentioned that you see significant amount of cash being released from the working capital cycle. Could you just explain how and why wouldn't this cash be required again, you know, going ahead if this is cyclical?
Let me take this question. Although we are currently contemplating buyback, if buyback has to happen, I will need three flows. That would be eased out by end of the season in working capital, because whatever funds are available with the company at the end of the year are all infused into the working capital to ensure a growth in the coming Kharif season. The season would be over. Your question, why the fund would be required, the company will definitely need funds if you are going for buyback.
No, sir. My question was, like you said rightly, that these funds are deployed for the growth of the company. So once these working capital cycle, when it eases and you pull out those funds for buyback, wouldn't there be a vacuum of funds which is required for growth next year?
Definitely no. The reason being very simple, that the profits also add. We have sufficient bank limit. The working capital got stretched this year because of enhanced cotton inventory, which has been eased out in the coming production. So that should not be an issue. The growth of the company will not be hampered even if we go for buyback.
Noted, sir. So the second question would be on the plant growth regulators market and the products that you have. Online also, there are a lot of videos. I don't know whether many participants have seen it or not, but the company has done a lot of things where the single product has been now multiple products, basically under the same brand is starting to come up. And you mentioned like granules and etc., other products also coming out. What I wanted to understand is that could there be a possibility of a tech transfer from your partner in China, whereas you can manufacture these products yourself over here? Because a lot of companies other than yourself, like even Godrej Agrovet, is tying up with companies abroad to transfer that tech to India and then manufacture those goods themselves.
So would you like to answer that?
I would like to answer this question. See, possibility of manufacturing in India will be explored the moment we feel that manufacturing here is cheaper than getting it from China. So that is the question. That's the single address. Then we feel that the manufacturing in India is cheaper. So until then, we continue to import. Whatever you need to do for this, two new products which you have launched are being manufactured here only. In India.
Okay, so the granules and the newer products in the portfolio are not imported. They are manufactured by the company. So the company is today a manufacturer of plant nutritional products.
Yes.
Okay, so
the value addition is being taken place in India. The raw material may be imported. Okay.
Noted, sir. Noted. So the third question would be on the illegal seed front. We are seeing a lot of news articles stating that there is a rampant increase in illegal cotton seed. And if I am not wrong, the two markets where the companies have significant presence is Gujarat and Maharashtra. And both these markets are significantly getting hit by these illegal seeds. So are we going to see a significant impact on and our growth being compromised because of this influx of these seeds?
Yeah, I'll answer this question, Devendran. You see, this illegal infiltration of illegal BT has definitely increased this year. And this will definitely impact not only us, all the organized seed players in the country. So we depend on sales, and then somebody, it's like somebody just coming before us and taking away the share of sales. And this definitely will be going to affect all the seed industry, including us. So we are, as I said, we are making efforts from the on the governmental front to stop this menace. But this is it's a difficult thing to control because it's widespread. Number one, number two, on the regulatory front, we are also encouraging and will work with the government that this is this event of HCBT is the right. Okay.
Yes, sir. Finally, on the GMS technology, your competitor, you know, has been stating that he has this technology and this will add significantly to his bottom line. Any comments whether the company is also having the same tech, and if not, by when will we have that tech so that we can also add significantly to our bottom line?
I would like to answer this question. I'm Vien Kulkarni here. Thank you for asking this question, and we are into it. And this year we are making a trial feed production with GMS lines, and hopefully we will be entering into commercial production next year.
Okay. Finally, sir, the last question: how much is the current pledge of the promoter entity? With which entity is this pledge, and by when is this pledge going to be released? Any timeline that the promoter entity has?
Let me answer that. The current promoter pledge has come down to less than 20%, which was around almost 35-40% earlier. And it is going to further reduce by another 5-10%. We have made some pledge to our bankers, which will definitely never go away. But leaving that aside, almost the entire pledge will be taken out before September.
Okay, so there are, what I'm seeing is through the documents, there are some private entities through which the pledges are being made. So all those pledges, you're saying that by September they'll be cleared and the pledge to the bankers, which are guaranteed, would stay.
Yeah, something like that. You're right.
Okay, sir. Noted, sir. Thank you so much for answering all the questions patiently, and best of luck for the coming years.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have a question, please press star on your telephone keypad. Next question comes from Nitin Dharmawat from Aurum Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. Sir, you talked about buyback, share buyback program. And I wanted to know what is the total consolidated net debt that we are having as of today. And since you also mentioned that you see some improvement in the working capital cycle, so what is the net consolidated debt that you see after that working capital cycle improve? So that's my first question.
Let me answer you on that. You are expecting me to tell you today how much of working capital will be eased out post-season. I think it's very difficult to predict at this particular level. The season has not even started. Right. So depending upon how much usable funds we have at that particular time, the contours will be contemplated. And I also have already mentioned that I need to take permission from my existing bankers. So today, my being able to tell you what exactly will happen after the permissions come or when the permissions come is a little difficult. You want to add me on that something? Sorry?
What is the net consolidated as of now?
We only have working capital, which is touching around 1996. My audited balance sheet has already been put on the this thing, so you can have a look at that. We have around 90 to 100.
90 to 100. Okay, got it. And okay, so that's the question that gets answered. About,
yeah. So let me add to that. Let me also add to that. Let it be noted that this company has got no long-term debts. We only have working capital bankers, and they are the only lenders to the institute, to the company.
Got it, sir.
Okay.
Second question. Yeah, and second question is regarding the rural demand. Since you mentioned that you see a change in the demand pattern now, so how is the demand now in the quarter one from the rural sector? If you can elaborate further on that.
Your questions are a little difficult to answer. Now, the rural demand is definitely changing because, let's say, for example, vegetable markets, mandis are not functioning well during this last few months, second wave. So, vegetable demand is vegetable. Fresh produce demand is little less. So, that automatically, the farmers are not coming to buy more seeds, right? So there are shifts in the cropping pattern. There are shifts in the way farmer is looking at raising the crop, and this is varying from geography to geography. So this is different in say Assam and different in Maharashtra or Gujarat. Like Rajasthan was very badly affected because of the very strict restrictions they imposed on movement of people. But okay, so that definitely has affected the rural the farmers' economy. So the impact has been different in different geographies, and I think by the time we go back end of July, things should have been normalized. But thank you. Okay.
Got it.
Thank you
so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have a question, please press star and one on your telephone keypad. Next question comes from Arvind Bhatt, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Good morning, sir. Hello.
Yeah, Mr. Bhatt, good morning. We are here.
Good morning, sir. Sir, aapne dividend announce kiya, bahut khushi mili, kyunki from last 20 years, I have been invested into this company. And this is a happy moment for me to get the dividend from the company. And thank you for that. And one more thing, sir. Actually, last year आपने इसका cotton seeds का जो एक future sales के बारे में आपने एक हमको एक data दिया था कि FY20 में आपका around sales रहेगा 15 lakhs package, then in FY21 25 lakhs रहेगा. तो आपका जो प्रेजेंटेशन देखा तो किधर भी आपने उसको मैच भी नहीं किया ड्यू टू कोविड एंड अनसर्टेन इससे भी रहेगा क्योंकि सेल्स डाउन है पर ये साल आपका टारगेट कितना है कॉटन सीड सेल्स में
बट साहब पहले तो डिविडेंड का शुक्रिया बोलने के लिए शुक्रिया
थैंक यू सर
क्योंकि आप जैसे शेयर होल्डर्स हमारे पास अनंत हैं जो सालों साल से कंपनी के साथ जुड़े हुए हैं जिनको कंपनी के ऊपर ट्रस्ट है भरोसा है और वो कंपनी के शुभ चिंतक हैं और कंपनी की ग्रोथ की इंतजार करते हैं कंपनी ग्रो कर भी रही है और आगे इससे भी अच्छा करेगी सो थैंक यू फॉर थैंकिंग अस सेकेंडली
यस
कॉटन की जो फिगर्स आपने दी है ये हमारी पुरानी प्रेजेंटेशन में थी जब हम ये चाह रहे थे कि कॉटन सुप्रीम हो जाए कॉटन कंपनी का मेजर कंट्रीब्यूटर बने लेकिन जब कॉटन की ओवरऑल ग्रोथ रुकी और हमको लगा कि भी कॉटन में सिर्फ रहने से कंपनी आगे जाके मुश्किल में आ सकती है तो उस टाइम पे हमने कंपनी की स्ट्रेटजी पिछले साल चेंज करी हमने बोला कि हम कॉटन में तो रहेंगे ही लेकिन उसके साथ साथ पैडी छोड़ के बाकी क्रॉप्स में भी आएंगे उसका फायदा इस साल हमको देखने को मिला कॉटन हमारी सेल्स रिटर्न में ज्यादा आई कॉटन के सिर्फ 13 लाख के आसपास पैकेट बिके अगर सिर्फ कॉटन पे निर्भर रहते थे तो कंपनी प्रॉफिट डिक्लेयर नहीं कर पाती थी। आगे भी कॉटन ऐसे ही ग्रो करेगी 10-15-20% डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द सिचुएशन। पैडी के अच्छे प्रोडक्ट आने के कारण उसमें एक्सपोनेंशियल ग्रोथ मिलने के चांसेस हैं, और बाकी फील्ड क्रॉप और वेजिटेबल और सप्लीमेंट के ऊपर हम ज्यादा जोर देंगे ताकि हमारा बैलेंस पोर्टफोलियो रहे और कंपनी अपनी ग्रोथ प्रोफाइल को मेंटेन कर सके।
सर आपका इस साल का टारगेट कितना है कंपनी का ओवरऑल सेल्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ सेल्स?
हमारी इच्छा 15-20% कम से कम करने की है। क्लैरिटी H1 के एंड तक हमको आ जाएगी कि इस साल खरीफ की जो क्रॉप्स की जो प्लांटिंग है या सेल्स हैं वो कोविड के रहते कितनी अच्छी हुई या कितनी खराब हुई।
ओके सर, वन मोर क्वेश्चन सर, आपने 2001 में जो चाइनीसी बीटी कॉटन में इन्वेस्टमेंट किया था वो टाइम में ऑलमोस्ट 10 इयर्स आपने उसमें लगा दिए थे मल्टीपल ट्रायल्स वगैरह करके, तो बाद में वो टेक्नोलॉजी टोटली फेलियर हो गई, आपको कौन सा मनसेंटो का एक बीटी कॉटन एक एडप्ट करना पड़ा, तो ऑलमोस्ट 10 इयर्स उसमें चले गए, और अगेन आपने इसमें फिलीपींस में सेम टेक्नोलॉजी को आगे रख के उधर आपने ऑलमोस्ट 4-5 इयर्स उधर लगा दिया अभी, सर अभी तक उधर से कुछ भी रिजल्ट नहीं है। आपने कौन से बेसिस पे फिलीपींस में आपको कितना सेल्स आपका मिलेगा नहीं तो कितना रेवेन्यू मिलेगा करके आपने 4-5 इयर्स उधर इन्वेस्ट किए?
बच्चा आपके बड़े गहरे रिसर्च करके प्रश्न किए गए हैं आपने तैयार। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट यू आर सो मच इन्वॉल्व्ड इनटू द कंपनीज प्रोग्रेस एंड सेवरल इनिशिएटिव्स दैट वी हैव टेकन इन द पास्ट। सो दिस डेफिनेटली टेक्नोलॉजी में इन्वेस्ट करना है, नए मार्केट्स में इन्वेस्ट करना है तो एक प्रोजेक्ट लेके चलना पड़ता है। तो जो फ्यूजन डीपी पे काम किया था तो बहुत यूनिक टेक्नोलॉजी का इंडिया में अल्टरनेट टू मोनसेंटो टेक्नोलॉजी लाने का प्रोजेक्ट था, काफी काम हुआ, काफी हद तक सक्सेस भी मिली, लेकिन ठीक है वी हैड टू गो टू अ न्यूअर बेटर टेक्नोलॉजी, हमको शिफ्ट करना पड़ा BG2 में मोनसेंटो की। दैट वाज द फर्स्ट फेज ऑफ योर क्वेश्चन। सो वी हैव टू इन्वेस्ट इन टेक्नोलॉजीज एंड न्यू मार्केट्स। यू टॉक अबाउट न्यू मार्केट्स ऑफ फिलीपींस में वी हैव द फर्स्ट मोर एडवांटेज एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू टू हैव दैट एडवांटेज फॉर लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम। और जैसे जैसे हमारे टेक्नोलॉजी और प्रोडक्ट्स वहाँ पे जाएंगे वॉल्यूम बढ़ते जाएंगे। आज हम वॉल्यूम को प्रेडिक्ट करना मुश्किल है, लेकिन इंडिया में भी जैसे टेक्नोलॉजी आती है तो वॉल्यूम बढ़ता है। एग्जिस्टिंग मार्केट साइज भले इतनी छोटी भी क्यों ना हो, अगर फार्मर को इनकम मिल रही है तो वो डेफिनेटली एरिया कॉर्नर में बढ़ने वाला है। तो फिलीपींस में वॉल्यूम भले छोटे थे, वी हैड फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड एडवांटेज। हमको ये भी इच्छा थी कि हमारी टेक्नोलॉजी को हम लोग दूसरे देश में ले जाएं, और वो हमारी कोशिश में हमको काफ़ी सक्सेस भी मिली, लेकिन ये कुछ रेगुलेटरी अप्रूवल्स डूब जाती है कई बार एंड दैट डिलेज द होल प्रोसेस, सो दैट इज वेर इट इज स्टक। आज की तारीख में एक लास्ट स्टेज पे रुका हुआ है वो, और होपफुली दिस ईयर दैट शुड हैपन। वी आर कंटिन्यू टू मेक आवर एफर्ट्स टू गेट इट रिलीज देयर इन फिलीपींस। वी आल्सो कंटिन्यू टू वर्क इन सेवरल न्यू मार्केट्स विथ टेकिंग अवर टेक्नोलॉजी टू द न्यू मार्केट्स लाइक फिलीपींस। जैसे हमने किया वैसे हम और देशों में भी हमारे कोशिशें जारी है, और इसमें समय लगता है, पेशेंस लगता है, जो इस इंडस्ट्री का और हमारे हमारे जैसे प्रमोटर की विशेषता है कि वी वर्क पेशेंटली, वी गिव टाइम, वी हैव टू हैव वर्क ऑन रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट्स वेयर जेस्टेशन पीरियड इज लिटिल लॉन्गर, बट फाइनली व्हेन इट कम्स वी हैव द एडवांटेज ऑफ बीइंग फर्स्ट मूवर और न्यू थिंग, समथिंग न्यू, समथिंग इम्पैक्ट मेकिंग। ठीक है
सर। ओके सर। सर और एक आपका जो अभी आपने अफ्रीका में और उज्बेकिस्तान ऐसा कई जगह आप अभी कौन सा ईस्ट एशिया में सब आप अभी इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं, आपका जो आपको कितना साल लगेगा उधर कुछ रेवेन्यू जनरेट होने में कितना साल लगेगा, क्योंकि ऑलमोस्ट अभी 2-3 साल से आप एफर्ट्स कर रहे हैं उधर इंटरनेशनल इस पे, तो आपको कितना और साल लगेगा?
या आई विल टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू आंसर यू। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट यू हैव टच्ड समथिंग व्हिच इज न्यूली हैपनिंग इन द कंपनी। In fact, Sudan were to begin this season itself, but the government has changed there. So that might delay. Probably next year we will be in the market with a good volume there. Our two-year trial has been happened, and we are going to register at least three products there, and that will be sold next year. We were aiming this year only. We struggled hard to organize the release meeting, but there are systems there. They work. Probably they might be happening in July also, by the time our season is over. So we aim for the next season. I'm very happy to say that Myanmar, we have already started. Again, you know that we have shipped the material. Because of the political doldrum there, the material has, part of the material has reached the farmers, they have planted, and part of that has not reached. However, we have got revenue, whatever we were aiming in at. The other one is, we are working with PwC, Price Auto Coopers in Uzbekistan. We probably by next month, we will be registering our company there. These are some of the updates, and in our neighbors, we are already in the market, and we are continue to be there, enhancing our market share there.
Okay. Sir, one more question. अभी future growth को देख के मेरा एक पूछना था आपसे, ऐसा कुछ multinational company को ऐसा stake वगैरह बेच के उनके साथ collaboration करके company को company ज़्यादा बढ़ सकती है international market में भी और डोमेस्टिक मार्केट में भी, ऐसा कुछ चांसेस आपको दिख रहा है सर?
नहीं, ऐसी कोई थिंकिंग वैसा अभी ना है ना हमको नजर आ रही है. हमको तो हमारी खुद की स्ट्रेंथ पे हम जहाँ जहाँ अच्छा काम कर सकते हम लोग कर रहे हैं और करते रहेंगे आज की तारीख में, है ना, ये हमारी आज की.
ओके सर, ओके ओके, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू, थैंक यू वेरी
मच. थैंक यू,
थैंक यू सर. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have a question, please press star and 1 on your telephone keypad. Next question comes from Sunil Modi, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Hello, Mr. Satish. Mera seedha ek sawal hai. Aapne jo kal presentation release kiya hai, usme likha hai ki you are suffering from working capital crisis. Knowingly that you are suffering from working capital crisis, why the meeting was, board meeting was called for buyback at this time? Timing is more important. When your Mr. Khurana is saying that you will have ease in working capital in Q2 or Q3, why you are calling board meeting at present to discuss buyback proposal when you are very well aware that you don't have that working capital to buy back?
Mr. Modi, let me answer that question.
Who is this?
Firstly, let me answer that question, I say. I am Khurana.
Nahin, aapka naam kya hai, sir?
Mr. Modi, I am Devinder Khurana. I am the CFO of the company.
I had addressed question to Mr. Satish. If he doesn't want to answer, let them tell you, let this to be answered by Mr. Khurana.
Okay.
Chara protocol thoda follow kariye, sir.
Mr. Modi, Mr. Satish Kagliwal will answer your question. Firstly, I would like to put across a point which you have wrong.
Mr. Khurana ji, meri baat suniye. Aapne iske pehle ek investor ka question aapne aadha answer kiya. Unhone pucha tha kitna pledge hai aur kaun se private financier se pledge kiya, uska naam chahiye. Aapne naam nahi diya.
Pehle main aapke sawal ka aadha jawab dunga, phir Kagliwal ji karenge.
ठीक है, मेहरबानी.
या प्लीज हैव पेशेंस. ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच.
पेशेंस है सर हमारे पास, हम 8 साल से इन्वेस्टर है, बिना डिविडेंड बिना कुछ बेनिफिट 8 साल से कंपनी से जुड़े हुए हैं, पर ऐसे कोनी पे गुड़ मत लगाइए आप. बायबैक का ऑफर कर बोलते पैसा नहीं है, Q3 में पैसा आएगा तो अभी क्यों बोर्ड मीटिंग बुलाया आपने?
ओके,
डोंट प्ले विद इन्वेस्टर, प्लीज आंसर नाउ.
पहली बात, we are not arguing on this forum. Please, my request. Let's maintain.
Where is argument? I am asking you, sir. I am asking you. Why board meeting was called when you are very well aware that you don't have fund?
Now, can I answer if you have done, please?
Point blank answer karna hai to kariyega. Point blank. Otherwise, let Mr. Satish answer this.
फर्स्टली आपने जो बोला दैट द कंपनी इज फेसिंग वर्किंग कैपिटल क्राइसिस, दैट इज द रॉन्ग स्टेटमेंट.
In your presentation, it is written. In your presentation, it is mentioned. But company, because of certain,
sir, the protocol says you ask a question and let the company answer. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Sorry. You also follow the protocol. Yeah.
Okay. Your statement or the statement being understood today that the company is facing working capital crisis is not correct. The presentation says the working capital is stretched. There is a difference between stretched and crisis. The working capital is stretched because of additional inventory of cotton which we had to carry. We are able to carry it subsequently over. There is no problem in that. Second is, the company doesn't have funds. Why should it announce buyback? We have said we are contemplating buyback. It has not been announced in this board meeting. It was only considered. I cannot announce buyback until I have a permission from my working capital lenders, the banks. Once the permission comes, the minutes clearly say we will take it back to the board for actual consideration. So two things I am clarifying. One, working capital is definitely not a crisis. It is always stretched at the end of March, because we have enough inventory to be placed in the market for the next year. And secondly, the buyback has not been announced. It is being contemplated. It is being considered. Now I can request Mr. Kagliwal to answer the balance of the thing.
So, sir, आपका ये प्रश्न क्या रहा है?
सतीश जी, पहले मेरी बात सुनिए. वर्किंग कैपिटल स्ट्रेस में है. मेरा क्राइसिस का मीनिंग वही है, स्ट्रेस है. चलो ठीक है, आई लेट अस गो बाय योर वर्ड ओनली, स्ट्रेस. Okay, जब आपकी कंपनी को मिस्टर कुराना जी को वेरी वेल, ही इज सीएफओ, उनको बरोबर पक्का मालूम है कि एट दिस मोमेंट, और आपका सीजनल बिजनेस है, ये सीजन में आपके पास कोई फंड नहीं होगा बायबैक के लिए. अननेसेसरी बोर्ड मीटिंग, और बोर्ड का टाइम क्यों वेस्ट कर रहे हैं? बोर्ड का टाइम वेस्ट किया, पूरे इन्वेस्टर्स का दो दिन तीन दिन एक वीक से इंतजार कर रहे हैं कि क्या आएगा बोर्ड मीटिंग में. अल्टीमेटली क्या डिसाइड किया बोर्ड मीटिंग में? कि हम बाद में विल कम आउट विद बेटर सॉल्यूशन. ये सब नहीं चलेगा सतीश जी. हम इन्वेस्टर्स हैं, आपकी कंपनी में बहुत टाइम से इन्वेस्ट करके बैठे हैं. कभी हमने आपको पूछा भी नहीं आप डिविडेंड दीजिए. हमने कभी कुछ नहीं बोला. वी आर जस्ट वेटिंग के आप अच्छी तरह से कंपनी को ग्रो करिए. ये सब जो अभी जो चल रहे हैं ना जुमले, वो पसंद नहीं आ रहे हमको. एज ए इन्वेस्टर हम आपको बोल देते हैं. हमको मैं तो सर आपसे मतलब बहुत बहुत प्रेम से आपके बात हर मीटिंग में आया, सब बात सुन रहा हूँ. पर ये जो आपने ये बार कोई गलत एडवाइजर की आके बोर्ड ने ये जो एजेंडा फिक्स किया बायबैक का, और बायबैक में अल्टीमेटली रिजल्ट ये आया कि हम बाद में देखेंगे, और आज ये बात हो रही है कि Q2 और Q3 में हमारे पास वर्किंग कैपिटल आएगा. सर, आपकी कंपनी इतने साल से यही टर्नओवर पे बिजनेस कर रही है, यही सब है. स्टॉक में और डेटर्स में, रिसीवेबल में पैसा पड़ा हुआ. आई डोंट नो वेदर रिसीवेबल में हकीकत से रिसीव होता है कि नहीं, वो क्वेश्चन दूसरा है मेरा. आई विल आस्क फॉर, आई विल रिक्वेस्ट यू टू गो फॉर ऑडिट.
दिस इज शीतल फ्रॉम गो इंडिया एडवाइजर्स. इफ यू हैव अ क्वेश्चन, कैन यू बी स्पेसिफिक अभी, क्योंकि हमारे बहुत इन्वेस्टर्स हैं जो क्यू में हैं.
मेरा स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन है मैडम कि ये बोर्ड मीटिंग क्यों बुलाई गई है जब मालूम है कि यू डोंट हैव मनी.
आंसर हो गया है, मिस्टर खुराना ने आंसर कर दिया. अगर आपके पास मिस्टर कागलीवाल के लिए कोई स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन है तो प्लीज.
जी है. सतीश जी, एक क्वेश्चन आगे इन्वेस्टर ने पूछा था, वो अधूरा रह गया है. इन्वेस्टर ने पूछा था जो शेयर्स प्लेज किए हैं तो कौन से इंस्टीट्यूशंस के पास प्लेज किए गए.
आपको अलग से दिए जा सकते हैं. दैट विल मच बेटर. जिसको भी चाहिए वो स्पेसिफिक आंसर दिए जा सकते हैं. जल्दी बात करने की यहाँ जरूरत नहीं है, है ना?
समझा नहीं मैं.
मिस्टर मोदी, हमारी टीम से आपको कोई कॉल करेंगे. दे विल एड्रेस ऑल योर क्वेरीज वन ऑन वन. वी हैव वेरी लेस टाइम.
ओके, अभी एक ही लास्ट सवाल है खुराना जी से. एक लास्ट सवाल है खुराना जी. अभी आप बोल रहे हैं Q2 और Q3 में आपका वर्किंग कैपिटल इज आउट होगा, तो आप कितना अमाउंट का आप बायबैक प्रपोज करोगे उसमें?
मोदी साहब, ये सवाल पहले भी पूछा, मैंने पहले भी इसका जवाब दिया. अब मैं फिर से वही लाइन दोहराने के लिए आप मुझे कह रहे हैं, मैं फिर से दोहराता हूँ. वर्किंग कैपिटल कितना ईज होगा, कितना बाईबैक होगा, कितने फंड्स आएंगे, कितने उनके अंदर इन्फ्यूज कर पाएंगे, ये आज की डेट में कहना कठिन है। मेरे इंस्टीट्यूशन लेंडर कितनी परमिशन देंगे ये भी आज कहना कठिन है। हमको करना है और मैंने ये बोला कि कंपनी की ग्रोथ बाईबैक के बेसिस पे हैम्पर नहीं होगी। आई कैटेगोरिकली मेड दिस स्टेटमेंट इन द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इटसेल्फ।
ठीक है, चलो
मोदी जी, आई जस्ट स्टार्ट एक्चुअली आई थिंक आई रियली एक्नॉलेज अप्रिशिएट योर बीइंग विद अस फॉर सेवरल इयर्स, वेरी
Satish ji, we have full faith in your management. Only question arises when there is an announcement of board meeting where the buyback will be discussed, and at the end of the meeting we have been informed that it has been deferred.
Modi ji, your point is well taken. Our intention should be taken as
sir. Next time, aap koi achhe financial advisor se baat karke fir board meeting kare, sab agenda fix kariye. ये इन्वेस्टर्स मैं आपको बताता हूँ सर, इन्वेस्टर्स आई एम इन टच विद मेनी इन्वेस्टर्स, हाई नेटवर्क इन्वेस्टर्स, एंड दे आर ऑल अपसेट विद दिस मूव। और एक बार इन्वेस्टर्स का विश्वास चला जाएगा ना, वापस आना बहुत टाइम लगता है सर।
मिस्टर मोदी, हम लोग ये डिस्कशन ऑफलाइन ले ले, वी हैव लॉट ऑफ पीपल वेटिंग इन द क्यू।
हाँ ठीक है, मेरा खत्म हो गया मैडम, मेरा बात खत्म हो गया।
चलो ठीक है, Shital, go ahead, please.
Thank you. Bharti, please take the next question.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, sir. So next we have a follow-up question from Mr. Nitin Awasthi from East India Securities. Please go ahead.
So a very, very specific question about a competitor who is backed by a very big conglomerate in India. So this JK Group, basically, this is a specific question I'm asking. So this company was not doing much for a long time now. And now the promoter entity is infusing a lot of punch into this company, and the company is stating they have big plans in Bangladesh. Now, is there something specific that this company has that they can do in Bangladesh, or is everybody, including us, also looking at Bangladesh? And specifically, the cotton market in Bangladesh.
Cotton seed market in Bangladesh. The question, your question is regarding a competitor. I would like to refrain from answering such question. If your question is regarding cotton seed market in Bangladesh, yes, cotton seed market in Bangladesh is growing, and Dr. Kulkarni can throw a little more light on that.
Every company has its own strategy. We saw that the growth in Bangladesh may not be as high as in Central Asian country, so we moved to Central Asian country where our competitors are not there. So strategies of placing our trades into a well-grown and well-identified markets are very important. We left Bangladesh because it's a very small, minuscule market. And we don't know why JK has gone there.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Noted, sir. Thank you for answering that question.
Thank you, sir. The next question comes from Anil Sharma from AB Capital. Please go ahead. Question comes from Ms. Preeti Singh from Value Investments. Please go ahead.
Hi, thank you for the opportunity. So, what is your opinion on the upcoming Kharif season? How will it affect the first half of FY22?
I could hear you clearly. Can you repeat the question, please?
So, what is your opinion on the upcoming Kharif season? And how will this affect the first half of FY22?
See, the Kharif season, as I said in the beginning itself, that the Kharif season, the sentiment is very positive because of the very favorable monsoon announcements which have taken place in the last 1 or 2 months, and the monsoon has been progressing well. There are, of course, little changes, aberrations and the deviations which happen, but overall the Kharif outlook is very good. Not only for us, for the Indian agriculture. And there will be an impact of COVID, despite of good favorable monsoon, there will be impact of COVID and restrictions and constraints that come with it. So we are upbeat on the Kharif this thing, and first half year will truly determine as to how we really do in the full year. Okay.
Okay. And what could be the upside from the news in Myanmar?
Myanmar is highly affected at the moment. Upside can be that some peace prevails there and we can work. So we are working in a tremendous constrained position there at the moment. We have registered the product, but we are not able to deliver it to the farmers, take it there, complete the process. So we have hit there a little bit of constraint in Myanmar. Okay?
Okay. Yeah, got it. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, ma'am. Ladies and gentlemen, due to time constraint, that would be the last question for the day. Now I hand over the floor to Mr. Devinder Khurana for closing comments. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for having joined us for this annual con call. We do it every quarter. At the outset, I would like to make a point that the company is putting in all the efforts to maintain a sustained growth irrespective of what is happening in the market. You would like to note that our gross margins around 50 plus have been maintained over the last 5 years to around 56% now. The EBITDA margin has almost become 1.5 times over the last 5 years, and the net profit margin has increased to almost double than that. The top line is growing, the bottom line is growing. We are into agriculture segment wherein COVID has given a negative impact basically because of logistics movement, because of movement of the market person being restricted by the government by not allowing to get out, and lastly because the farming community also was not able to come out properly. In spite of that, the company is growing. Secondly, we are thankful to the investors who have been invested with us for years altogether. I personally am here for almost 20 years plus, and I know investors who are here with us since Nathseed's time. We have been contemplating giving something back to the investors, which we were unable to do because we wanted to grow. So invariably, all the internal accruals were infused back into the company for the growth. But this year, we felt it was high time that we started rewarding back investors irrespective of the increase in share price. The first step towards that is dividend. Now that we have started the dividend, that would become a continuous process. Apart from that, we thought we will see whether we can go for the buyback, which we are still very seriously contemplating, and we are very serious about it. Having said that, I would now like to genuinely thank everybody for being here with us. My request will be, have trust in the growth of the company and stay invested. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes your conference for today. Thank you for your participation and for using Door Sabha's conference call service. You may disconnect your lines now. Thank you and have a pleasant day.